Harper Audio presents Never Fall Down by Patricia McCormick, performed by Ramon de Ocampo. Chapter 1, Battambang, Cambodia, April 1975. At night in our town, it's music everywhere. Rich house, poor house, doesn't matter. Everyone has music. Radio, record player, 8-track cassette. Even the guys who pedal the rickshaw cycle. They tie a tiny radio to the handlebar and sing for the passenger. In my town, music is like air. Always there. All the men, all the ladies stroll the park to catch the newest song. Cambodian love song, French love song, American rock and roll. Like the Beatles, like Elvis, like Chubby Checker. Ladies in sarong walk so soft, like floating on the street. Men in trouser, hair slick back, smoking Lucky Strike. Old men playing card. Old lady selling mangoes, selling noodle, selling wristwatch. Kid flying kite, eating ice cream. The whole town is out at night. My little brother and me, we stand in front of the movie palace and sing for them. We do the twist also. Let's twist again, like we did last summer. Two skinny kid, no shoe, torn pants. They like it if we sing for them. They even give us a few coin. Tonight I study the crowd. Find a lady. Fat one. Fat like milk fruit. And slowly, slowly, very sneaky, my brother and I, we hide behind her skirt. Hold on so light she doesn't know. And pretend she's our mom. Kid with parent can see the movie for free. Kid like us? We pretend. Inside the movie palace, we watch America. Black and white, with airplane, shiny car, and women in skirts so short they show the knee. War movie. Lot of shooting, and a little bit kissing. For the shooting, my brother and me, we clap. For the kissing, we hide our face in our shirt. After the show, it's the best part, when we do the movie ourselves. Outside in the park, we fly the plane, shoot the gun, be the hero. Just like the real soldier fighting right now in the jungle outside of our town. We shoot probably 100 bullet, die 100 time. Then, we hear a whistle, and the sky far away flash white. The palm trees shiver, and the ground shake. And all of a sudden, the war is real. I grab my little brother's hand, and run till we get to a little pond near our house. We jump in, water up to our nose, and hide there, where nothing bad can find us. Next day, the music is back, and the war is gone. Sometime the war come close, but never into our city. Most of the fighting, the radio says, it's far away, in the jungle. Government soldiers, they fight for the prince. The bad guys? I don't know what they're fighting for, but I do know the prince is a great man. A great man with important friend, like the widow of the young American president. And beautiful daughter I saw in the newspaper when she and the prince go to China. So pretty, I cut the picture for my wall. I worry about those two in China. The Chinese eat bad-smelling food. Where are they gonna eat? How are they gonna get home with all this fighting? But one soldier at the market, high-ranking guy, he brag about the government fighters. He's a big, bull-neck man, this guy who says he know the prince. He says the war only gonna last 1 week. He says the soldiers in the jungle, they not real soldiers. Only peasant in black pajama. Not even with real boot. Sandal made from old tire. We gonna win, he says. We gonna squish them like cockroach. So I try not to worry about the prince and princess, and worry instead about how I can make a little money. Sometime I sell ice cream. To sell, you have to have a bell. A small bell. It sound when you walk, so people hear you coming. But poor kid like me, I buy a cheap one. Old bell for buffalo. Big. Not good sound. Like old gong around my neck. At first, nobody buy. Nobody buy my ice cream because I look like poor kid. So I eat all the ice cream before it melt. Make myself almost sick. I learn a lesson then. Sell fast before the ice cream melt. Sell fast. Also, go far. All over town. I walk so much, I know this town like my pocket. A lot of time, kid throw stone at me. Rich kid. Kid who go to real school, with desk and a hoop for basketball. Not like temple school for poor kid like me, where you have to do chore, serve the monk, then maybe get a little teaching. Rich kid, they make a face at me, throw stones. Sometime I run. Sometime I make a face at them too, then run. But soon, I learn another lesson. You want to sell? You sneak out from the temple and sell when those kid in school. My number one big sister, Shantu, she find out I'm not at the temple. She get mad. Very mad. An, she say to me, you should be doing chore for the monk, learning the chant, doing schoolwork. Selling ice cream, that's low class. I don't tell her the monks sometime are very mean. I don't tell her they make us work all the time and that temple is not like real school. I don't tell her they get angry. They hit and say, you stupid boy. Also, I don't tell her we are low class. She still think like the old days when our family owned the opera. My dad the star. My mom also the star. In our house, big house on the main road, before the show, it was all singer and musician staying with us, getting ready. 40 people maybe. A show every Saturday. Packed. So crowded, some people have to sit on the grass. Our family a little bit rich, a little bit famous. Then, my father has a motorcycle accident. Hit his head on the road. At the hospital, he yell like it's still the opera, like still on stage. Then he die. And my mom? She can't run the opera anymore. She try. But no leading man, no opera. So she has to go far away, to Phnom Penh, to sing and make a little money. And we live with our aunt. Me and my brother and four sister. My aunt, she have no kid, so she love us like her own, but not enough money. That why I go stay at the temple sometime. Why I also try to make money on my own. I don't say any of this to my sister. I let her say that it's low class what I'm doing. I want money, but also I want to have fun. Maybe it's low class, but it's okay for me. Sometime, I steal coconuts. Sometime, the lady next door, she let me pick the flower to sell. And sometimes, I play a game for money. You can say it's gambling, but maybe you can say it's sport also. Doesn't matter. I give the head monk a little money so I can sneak out of the temple to play. You can say maybe I bribe him. Or you can say maybe I give him a little gift. this game? It's easy for me. You draw a circle on the ground and put money there. You throw your shoe. You hit the money, you take it. I lose sometime, but most the time, I win. I play not only with kid, I get so good, many time I play with the men, the cyclo driver. I tease them. I say, "You so fat, you can't see over your belly, man." And they get mad, and they throw the shoe like crazy, and I win. No other little kid has money like me. This mean I can buy things for my family. Good food, grill banana, coconut cake, mung bean pudding. Always I give the best thing to money, my little brother. Palm sugar, very sweet, wrap in palm tree leaf. But one time, when I give a treat to my aunt and my sister, they cry. I don't know what's going on with them. I say, "Why you cry?" They ask where I got this money. "A little boy like you, how you get so much money?" They keep pinching me, and say maybe I steal it. I tell them the truth, that I win it, but they don't believe. They go see the head monk. They take me too, pinching my ear all down the street. "An got a lot of money," they say. "Where he got it from?" The monk shake his head like this is very sad news for him. He tell them the truth about the shoe game. And he says, "An try to give me some money too, but I don't take it." I rub my ear and think, next time, no money for that guy. In our town is a tree that make hard little seed ball. Buffalo toe tree. You shake it, the seed, they fall on the sidewalk. You cut down a reed, you stick the seed inside, you make a blowgun. My little brother, he says tonight he's gonna shoot our sister in the butt for telling our aunt we sneak in the movie. This sister, Sophia, she's in the middle of us. Younger than me, older than him. Our favorite for shooting at. Also, she swear and says curse word when we hit her, and our aunt get mad at her instead of us. I hug this tree, shake it hard, and hear, far off, sound like thunder. I look at the cloud and wait for rain to fall like curtain, for the umbrella to pop up like mushroom, for the hot season to end, and the rainy time to start. But no rain is coming. Only truck. All kind of truck. Mostly jeep and tank, but also Coca-Cola truck and bus and garbage truck, all full of soldiers. Young guys. Dark skin and tough, all in black. Black pajama. Black cap. Only with red and white scarf tied around the head. Most are kid, teenagers. Some of them only a little bit older than me. Kid with sandal made from car tire. Kid with gun. And lot of bullet across the chest. And pistol. And grenade. Some soldier are even girl. Girl with short hair. Angry face. Now people coming out of all the house. Cheering, waving white flag, handkerchief, bedsheet maybe, scarf, everything white. They run up to the truck and try to touch the soldier. Next to me, a guy in blue jean, hair and sideburn like Elvis, he wave at the truck. I ask him what's going on. He says, "The war is over." Up and down, the street people cheer and yell and wave the flag. One guy, a cook, he wave a big spoon, also his apron. The guy who cut the hair, he shake a white towel. One old lady, no teeth, pink gum like a baby, she tried to kiss one soldier. Horn honking. Little kid, they run around in circles. Dog even, they chase their tail. So I run around, losing myself too. I don't know who are these guy with gun and truck, but I don't care. No more war. Maybe now the princess can come home.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.